these cars make, and of course they haven't grown up. The problem is the same as it was when we started 30 or so years ago. The cars haven't got bigger, they've stayed the same size, they've never outrun the tracks.
Oh, this is on now, that's for the lead!
Parker!
Oh, Rosie Parker in the floor, get down the inside, job done! That was two into the first lap, so he's done two, and he's into the lead, brilliant! Look at the Irish line trying to get around! The outside of it, good girl! We're gonna start going flying here, this is getting on! Watch and learn!
They may well do this, second group of three need to work with each other not to lose touch with the leaders. So it's Jack Parker looking for a double here. Remember, he won race one. He started a long way back in race number one, did Jack Parker. And he's got into the lead of this one. Runs wide, two cars. Off goes Ben against the camera car. And off goes Ollie Slope as well, the two protagonists in last year's rookie championship. Both up into the ground, but the race continues up front.
Yeah, the race continues up front as a change in the lead. Oh, look at that, Arnold's down on the inside. He's got it done in the 87. Perfect move. But there's got to be a safety car, there's got to be. But look, it's five for the lead. Safety car, and he's got it just done right in time.
Yeah.
Hand out the cockpit. Slow down, boys.
Yeah, they have a race team, so they get radio signals from race control to tell them what's going on. Some of them obviously not perhaps quite soon enough. And going around there is Chris Needham. That one, that's Chris Needham in the 13 car, the ex-supercar. It's a three-car team. Chris Needham, Matt Isherwood, and Gareth Sheridan all run together. And those cars have been, that could well be the result declared there. Matthew Knight's got the fastest lap of the race, incidentally.
That's a shame, that's going to be two problems for the marshals and the recovery team. So, and lap 8 is now on. I think they're going to have to call this. I hope they don't, but I think they will have to. We're on a real tight schedule.
The bonus is, if it does get called, it saves us a little bit of time on the day, and we might get a look at the third race later on of these cars. And if not, we'll see them again at Croft. Look forward to seeing them at Knockhill. But a self-contained championship, we will see this championship go to the end. Here's a replay.
Yeah, so it was all kicking off, wasn't it? It was side-to-side contact, was it? Or was it a bit more malicious than that? Schluck in the 9.
Oh! Ben lost it a little bit, didn't he?
Ben lost the rear, touched Schluck on the left, the right rear of his car, and then just ran him off. That was absolutely no good spot. That was such a horrible racing incident. This is proper stuff. Listen to the speed of this as we go off into paddock. And you're going to see it now. So this is that over speed. Look at the car on your left. Oh, it's actually, it's such a shame. That car, I've said on my all along, is very oversteery. The rear axle hasn't got any grip, and he just loses the wheel and fires into it. Such a shame, because look, the car looks back and lifts it into the rear right corner. Schluck had nowhere to go, and that was game over for the number 9. And